TigerVision is proudly sponsored by American Family Insurance.
What up, my broskies? Welcome to TigerVision.
Let's get into the announcements.
Seniors, please check your email this week for an invitation to apply for the Martin Luther King Jr. Peace Scholarship. The invitation email includes a link to the application. The application deadline is Friday, December 20th. See Mr. CG in room E209 with questions.
The food drive has been extended into December. Student Council needs you to band together as a Flex and start bringing in those food and cash donations. Flex teachers, reminder that you should be bringing all donations to Katie in the back office. Thanks, and let's work together to help our school and community.
Attention students, please look at your second semester schedules in the school tab on Student View. If you are missing a class or need to make a change, please make an appointment with your counselor. You have between now and winter break to make schedule changes. Those schedule changes will be made once class resumes in January.
Hello everyone, NHS is doing something a little different this year and we are having a Candy Cane Grahams fundraiser. This fundraiser will start later this week. When it starts, you'll receive an email from the school, and in that email will be a Google form that you can fill out to purchase your Candy Cane Grahams. They are $1 each, you can buy as many as you'd like. So in that form, just fill out who you'd like to give it to, if you want to give them a message, and then you can pick whether you want it to be anonymous or whether you want them to know who it's from. Once you fill out that form, you can then go to the table at lunch. Candy cane grams are $1, and it's a great way to just spread some love during this holiday season and show people how much you appreciate them.
The Sideline Store program was built to give fans the ability to purchase customized, branded, print-on-demand apparel and accessories. You can shop by designs and brands, which includes Nike, Lululemon, Carhartt, and more. Personalize your gear by adding your own name and number, or making fan shirts of your favorite Tiger. The Albert Lea High School Sideline Store has unlimited products and design options, including shirts, pants, hats, drinkware, and decals.
The Care Closet is open. If you need clothes, shoes, school supplies, hygiene supplies, laundry done for you, access to a shower, or anything else, they have you covered. You have a form in your email, and you can fill in your needs.
This week's Tiger Pride letter is G. G stands for grit.
What grit means to me is working hard and never giving up, no matter what you're going through.
Grit means to me persevering through obstacles and difficult challenges in your life.
Oh my God, did you guys see what happened yesterday?
No, what happened?
Do you guys literally live under a rock?
Bree, shut up.
You guys do live under a rock.
Shut up, Brooke!
Okay, you gotta stay focused.
Sorry. It's fine, it's fine.
A situation when I've had to use grit is balancing life as a student and an athlete and really making sure that I'm giving my all to both my sports and my academics and just persevering through hard times and giving my best to both of them.
Remember, having grit is important because in life there will be obstacles and setbacks, but having grit will help you achieve your goals.
Video games just aren't fun anymore. I've been playing Fortnite for about as long as I can remember now, and it just doesn't hit the same. I don't know why. I have my LED lights and I live by the gamer code, but it's still not fun anymore. So I decided to go back to the beginning of gaming to find a way to love again.
Then I saw what the first video game looked like and decided to go for the next best thing. Mega Man was an action platformer released in 1987 by Capcom. I was 12 when it came out and, oh my word, I'm almost 50. And I remember going to the store and I was just entranced by the artwork, only to find out that the game looked like this. That's the most experience I ever had with it, so I'm finally giving it a second go today. So, let's get into it. This game lets you choose any of the six main stages in any order, so I decided to go to the Gentleman Gutsman first. I began Gutsman stage by trading fire with some hard hats. It was a battle, to be certain. I then took a ride on some pulleys, and I might have fallen off once or twice, but I was eventually able to make it over, in which I was ambushed by some flying mouth things, but I overcame it because I'm a gamer. I then fought a guy with a hammer, but I overcame it because I was a gamer. Went down the hole, I fought the toughest enemy yet, the big guy. It was quite the tough battle, David and Goliath to be exact, but I overcame it since I was a gamer. Then I made it to Gutsman's house. I ran down the entry hallway, and finally, to fight Gutsman. The strategy is quite simple. All he does is just throw rocks at you, so you can jump over and shoot him, which I did. And that was one easy first level. Gutsman gave me an arm to throw rocks, so I decided to go to Cutman next, because, you know, rock beats scissor. The level began with me being ambushed by the flying mouth things again, but I overcame it with such ease. Then I started climbing some ladders, but these turrets, they just kept trying over and over to stop my ascent. But I'm just built different. Then this house just started throwing scissors at me. Strange way to stop an intruder. Next few rooms weren't that interesting, a lot of them just had these eyes flying back and forth, but you know, I'm a gamer, so I overcame it with great ease. Then this room was interesting as this shell guy just tried shooting me, but I outran him. Finally, before Cutman's house, I encountered Big Eye again. This time, I was a little too close for comfort, but you know, I'm a gamer, so I overcame it. And then, I finally made it to Cutman's house. In this entry hallway, I decided to re-energize myself, you know. And then, the boss battle. It was quite simple to say the least. These two rocks right here are enough just to make him go kablammo. After easily defeating Cutman, I decided to go to Electman because I heard his stage theme sound like a Journey song. I began the level by defeating these evil Roombas because they weren't really even cleaning the place, like it looks dirty in here. I started my ascent toward the heavens, but then these UFOs tried shooting me down with their lasers. I then had to play with some blocks that just came out of the wall. Then I used Gutsman's arm to grab a special weapon, which will be used for later. Finally, at the peak of my ascent, I ran into another big eye, but you know, I'm a gamer like that, so I overcame him with quite ease. And then, I was at Electman's house. One more ascent upward, and then this happened.
It's Red Week for music lessons.
FFA Crops will practice on Thursday at 7:45 a.m. in F208.
FFA Agricultural Mechanics will practice on Wednesdays from 3:15 to 5 in F204.
Chess Club meets every Thursday from 3 to 4:30 p.m. in E209. Players of all skill levels are welcome, even if you've never played before. It's fun and free, and come when you can.
Spanish Club will meet Thursdays from 3 to 3:30 in E106. All students are welcome.
Guitar Club is meeting at 3:15 in E213 on Wednesday. You do not need to have a guitar or any playing experience to join us. We have guitars and knowledge to share if you are curious to try playing, or you can just come to listen. If you have a guitar, you are welcome to bring it. Please see Mr. Flores or Mr. Lang if you have any questions.
Today for lunch is buttermilk pancakes.
We will send it over to Sportsnet.
Albert Lea girls basketball falls to Worthington 53-66. Aaliyah Heidenman and Novaya Waffles led the Tigers with 20 points each, with Waffles nothing 11 rebounds, as well as Jalen Boss added 9 points.
while going to the three-trail ride 12 times. The reigning Section 1A champs, the Northfield Raiders, handed the Albert Lea Tigers at their first loss of the 24-25 season. The score is 5-0. Albert Lea's goalie, Ledger Stadheim, made 40 saves in the defeat.
Have a great Tiger Day.